Good morning, children. Yesterday we were reading part 1 of the Happy Prince. So we came to know that there was a statue which was made of gold, and then rubies and sapphires were there on the sword and the eyes, and he was helping the poor people to giving them, and a sparrow helped him to go and give the ruby and sapphire to the people who are in need of that. So the bird which wanted to go to Egypt stayed there because Happy Prince asked the bird to be its messenger for one day. So after helping the poor seamstress, second day when it was very happily going to Egypt, it asked Prince, is there any work that I can do before I go to the Egypt? Then he asked for one more help. So now let us go and see what happened, whether the bird stayed back and helped the prince for the second time to be its messenger or not. Let us see now. Dear prince, said the swallow, I cannot do that. And he began to weep. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, do as I command you. So the swallow plucked out the prince's eyes and flew away to the young man's garret. It was so easy enough to get in, as there was a hole in the roof. Through this, he darted and came into the room. The young man had his head buried in his hands, so he did not hear the flutter of the bird's wings. And when he looked up, he found the beautiful sapphire lying on the withered violet. So the sparrow told the prince that I cannot do that. What was that it cannot do? What did the prince asked the sparrow to do? The king asked the swallow to pluck the sapphire which is there to his eye and go and give that to the man who could not write the stories. So to take out the eye from the prince's eye, the sparrow could not do that. Then that's why the prince told the swallow, 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 little swallow, said the prince, do as I command you. So do, pluck my eye and go and give it to the man. So the swallow plucked the prince's eye and flew away and went and gave to the man who could not write stories and who was just keeping his head, covering his face and then sitting there. And as he was bending his head, he could not even listen the fluttering of the wings. Then when he opened his eyes, he saw that the sapphire between the withered violets. Okay. I am beginning to be appreciated, he cried. This is from some great admirer. Now I can finish my play. And he looked quite happy. So after seeing the sapphire, he felt really happy. What did he tell? This is from some great admirer, somebody who really loved my stories. Who is my admirer? That person must have sent this sapphire to me. And he was very happy. The next day, the swallow flew down to the harbor. He sat on the mast of a large vessel and watched the sailors working. I am going to Egypt, cried the swallow. But nobody minded. And when the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. So it was so happy that it was going to his friends. So it shouted, I am going to Egypt. But the sailors who were working there in that harbor did not even pay any attention to what the swallow was telling. So next, when the moon rose, night time, again the swallow went to the happy prince. I have come to bid you goodbye, he cried. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, will you not stay with me one night longer? It is winter, answered the swallow, and the snow will soon be here. In Egypt, the sun is warm, and the grass, palm leaves, and the crocodiles lie in the mud and look lazily about them. So the poet, the swallow, was telling that it can't stay there because it's winter season is about to come and it has to go to the Egypt where the weather will be really very warm. Now, in the square below, said the prince, there stands a little match girl. She has let her matches fall into the gutter and they are all spoiled. Her father will beat her if she does not bring home some money, and she is crying. She has no shoes or stockings and her little head is bare. Pluck out my other eye and give it to her, and her father will not beat her. I will stay with you one night longer, said the swallow, but I cannot pluck out your eye. You would be quite blind then. So, look at the girl. She was there and she was a match girl and match sticks. She was making and selling them. So, by mistake, what happened? That all the match sticks fell into the gutter and she could not sell them. And if she goes home like that, the father will beat the girl. And she is very poor girl. Look at her in this winter season. She did not have a scarf and she did not have stockings. And she is really very poor and her father will beat. So, please take out the other sapphire from my eye and go and give that to the little girl. So to do that, the swallow was really feeling very sad. Then she said, I can't do that. Taking out your one more eye. One eye you all have already given to the writer. Now if I take the other eye, then you will be blind. You can't see anything. How can I do that? It's not possible, was the answer given by the bird. But swallow, swallow, little swallow, do as I command you. So when the prince asked her to take out, she was left with no other option. So he plucked out the prince's other eye and darted down with it and swooped past the match girl and slipped the jewel into the palm of her hand. So she gave that to the match girl. What a lovely bit of glass, cried the little girl, and she ran home laughing. Very happily she went home, seeing the sapphire in her hands. Then the swallow came back to the prince. You are blind now, he said. So I will stay with you always. No, little sparrow, said the poor prince. You must go away to Egypt. No, I will stay with you always, said the swallow, and he slept at the prince's feet. Now, as the prince became blind, as he could not see anything, the bird felt it's not correct for her to leave the prince like that and go away to Egypt, thinking of her own comforts. So she told, I'm not going anywhere. I'll stay with you always. All the next day, he sat on the prince's shoulder and told him stories of what he had seen in strange lands. Dear little swallow, said the prince, you tell me of marvelous things, but more marvelous than anything is the suffering of men and women. There is no mystery so great as misery. Fly over my city, little swallow, and tell me what you can see. So the bird went round and started looking everywhere and coming back and telling prince, you know what is there? So all beautiful things the sparrow started telling the prince. Then what happened? The happy prince told, it's really very beautiful, but more than that, is the beauty is in the suffering of the men and women. So I want that stories where people are really suffering. See, please go and tell me where the people are suffering and how they are suffering. So the swallow flew over the great city and saw the rich making merry in their beautiful houses while the beggars were sitting at the gates. He flew into dark lanes and saw the white faces of starving children looking out listlessly at the black streets. Under the archway of a bridge, two little boys were lying in each other's arms to try to keep themselves warm. How hungry we are, they said. You must not lie here, shouted the watchman, and they wandered out into the rain. Then he flew back and told the prince what he had seen. I'm covered with fine gold, said the prince. You must take it off leaf by leaf and give it to the poor. The living always think that gold can make them happy. So now it went round and saw all the sufferings of the people. And then it came and told the prince. There are many happy people, the rich people are really very happy. They are enjoying, whereas the poor people in streets and small children without proper clothing, they were really suffering. Two boys, when they were lying there and they were trying to keep themselves warm, the watchman came and told them that you are not supposed to be here, go away. Then they came, then they went away from that place. Now the prince told that, see, my entire body is covered with leaves of gold. What you need to do is you take out each and every leaf of that and go and give to the people really who are really suffering. So they feel that this gold can make them happy, because they will sell that and get some money and they will buy whatever they want. So you please do that. The happy prince told the swallow, and then the swallow very seriously started taking out and giving all that to the poor people. So leaf by leaf, everything given. Leaf after leaf of the fine gold, the swallow picked off till the happy prince looked quite dull and grey. Leaf of the fine gold he brought to the poor, and the children's face grew rosier and they laughed and played in the streets. "We have bread now," they cried. So, no doubt the prince became very dull, but the children's face glowed because they were able to eat. They could get some bread to eat. Then the snow came, and after the snow came the frost, the streets looked as if they were made of silver. Everybody went about in furs, and the little boys wore scarlet caps and skated on the ice. The poor little swallow grew colder and colder, but he could not leave the prince. He loved him too well. He picked up the crumbs outside the baker's door when the baker was not looking, and tried to keep himself warm by flapping his wings. So winter came, and everywhere there was a snow, and the bird could not bear that wind. So it used to go to the baker's place and get some bread crumbs to eat, and then living there because it could not leave the happy prince. So now it was really suffering in that cold weather. But at last he knew that he was going to die. He had just enough strength to fly up to the prince's shoulder once more. "Goodbye, happy prince," he murmured. "Will you let me kiss your hand? I'm glad that you are going to Egypt at last." "Little swallow," said the prince, "you have stayed too long here, but you must kiss me on lips, for I love you." "It is not Egypt that I'm going," said the swallow. "I am going to the house of death. Death is the brother of sleep, is he not?" And he kissed the happy prince on the lips and fell down dead at his feet. At that moment, a curious crack sounded inside the statue, as if something had broken. The fact is that the leaden heart had swapped right in two. It certainly was the dreadfully hard frost. Early the next morning, the mayor was walking in the square below the company with the town councillors. As they passed the column, he looked up at the statue. "Dear me, how shabby the happy prince looks," he said. "How shabby indeed," said the town councillors, who always agreed with the mayor, and they went up to look at it. Look at this, children. It was really very touching. So this swallow, it came to the happy prince up. It knew very well that it has enough strength only to go up to the head of the happy prince. Went and told, "I'm leaving now. May I kiss your hand?" And the happy prince felt that, "Oh, I'm really very happy that you are going to Egypt. You stayed with me for many days." But the bird said, "No, I'm not going to Egypt. I'm going to..." The happy prince asked, "Not on my hand. You kiss on my lips because I love you so much." So now it's told that, "I'm not going to Egypt, but I'm going to the house of death." And so told that it was going to die. And then it kissed the princess, happy prince lay on the lips, and fell down at his feet. And that at that moment, the heart of this happy prince inside, it was broken into two pieces, which means even the prince also died along with the bird. And next day, when these councillors and the mayor, when all came, they could see only the physical beauty of the golden statue. No sapphires, no ruby, no gold, and it's looking dirty. So they cannot see the inner beauty of the prince and even the bird. So now what happened? The ruby had fallen out of his sword. His eyes are gone and he is golden no longer, said the mayor. In fact, he is little better than a beggar. So decided that he was not beauty, little better than a beggar, said the town councillors. And here is actually a dead bird at his feet, continued the mayor. We must really issue a proclamation that birds are not to be allowed to die here. And the town clerk made a note of the suggestion. So we should tell the birds not to die at the feet of the prince. So we should tell them that. So he pulled down the statue of the happy prince. As he is no longer beautiful, he is no longer useful. And the art professor at the, said the art professor of the university. So what are they doing there? Breaking the statue. Then they melted the statue in a furnace. What a strange thing, said the overseer of the workmen at the foundry. This broken lead heart will not melt in the furnace. We must throw it away. So they threw it on the dust heap where the dead swallow was now was also lying. So the entire body, which was made of lead, melted. But the heart, it did not melt. So what did they do? They threw the heart outside. And that heart went and felt exactly where the sparrow was dead. Now what happened? Bring me the two most precious things in the city, said the god to one of his angels. And the angel brought him the leaden heart and the dead bird. So you can see the heart and the bird were there. And when God asked the angel went and brought the heart and the bird. You have rightly chosen, said God, for in my garden of paradise, the little bird shall sing for evermore, and in my city of gold, the happy prince shall praise me. So when the God asked to bring, the angel went and brought heart and sparrow, and the God was really very happy because those two were really the precious things according to the God also. So children, what is it we have learned in this is death is inevitable. Everybody is going to die one day. But what is it we are going to do for others? How are we going to help others? That is the ultimate thing in this story. And I hope that you have enjoyed the story. Thank you so much. And there are questions at the end of the lesson. Please complete that work and read the lesson one more time. Thank you.